my strength this hour, Jesus. You're my deliverer, yes, you are, Jesus.
The goodness of Jesus. I'm Vivian Brown. Thank you so very much for joining us today. Well, it has been a little while since I recorded any videos. I have been so very, very busy, but you know, I am just grateful right now that God has allowed me to come before you again. I am on vacation and I am able to catch up on God's word with you. Well, let's go ahead and open up with a prayer because that's enough of me, and let's dive into his word for today. Dear Heavenly Father, we honor your name this day. We bless your name this day. Father, we thank you for what you have done in our lives. We thank you for what you are doing in our lives, and we thank you for what you will do in our lives. We thank you, Father, for showing us you are God, and you are God alone. Father, we love you this day, Father, and we are just so very, very grateful to be in your presence from day to day. Father, I pray for those that fall under the sound of my voice. I pray and ask that whatever word that you have for them, that you allow me to speak it and you help them to be open, Father, to receive this word. Father, I ask you to use me to inspire those that need to be inspired today, Father. Father, we love you again, and we thank you so much for who you are and for what you do in our lives from day to day. It's in your darling son's name we pray. Amen. It occurs in 261 verses throughout the Bible, used in many of stories, present in our everyday lives, whether we acknowledge it or not. When God withholds the punishment we so rightfully deserve, he's showing us his mercy. Now, on the other side of mercy, this word appears 206 times throughout the Bible. It goes hand in hand with mercy. It loves to be right by mercy's side. When God blesses us despite our evil and wicked ways, he's showing us his grace. So when we don't get what we deserve, that's mercy. And when we get what we don't deserve, that's grace. God's mercy and his grace is our message for today. You know, when I started thinking about God's mercy and his grace, I couldn't help but to think back on the times when I couldn't help but to acknowledge that it was his mercy and grace that saved me from a particular situation. But ultimately, when I think about his mercy and his grace, I can't help but to think about his ultimate sacrifice when he sent his only begotten son to the cross to die for our sins. moment and think about the sin we commit on a daily basis. Jesus died on the cross so we don't have to. You know, God's mercy was evident up on that cross to me because he didn't give us what we so rightfully deserved, death, our life. And his grace was evident for me because he gave us, or he blessed us with what we so rightfully did not deserve, his only begotten son, Jesus. Quite often we go from day to day and we take God's mercy and his grace for granted. We sometimes act as if we really do deserve his mercy and his grace despite our everyday actions. You know, I think about how when we wake up in the mornings, his mercy and grace greets us as we start our day and we leave out of our homes and our children. His mercy and grace wraps itself around us, even when we forget to ask. If it has ever been any doubt in your mind that his mercy is present this day, let me help you put that to rest. I was able to find a couple of miracles that most definitely showed his mercy and his grace, and I want to share that with you. Take a look at this.
The road is clear. He decides to overtake. He slips on the road. The truck coming bashes onto him. There you go. Something falls out. There you see, right on your left corner, is the baby who's just literally flowed out of this moving car into oncoming traffic. Now, what's more surprising about this is that the father comes out. Luckily, this driver is quite, you know, he's pretty much aware of what's going on around him. He picks up the kid, goes back into the car, his wife comes out, picks up what's left of everything there. Now, this video...
I'm coming, honey. Where you at, honey? It's bad. All right, stay down, honey. Oh, Josie. Uh-oh. We're going to get shit here, honey. I hope so, honey. Oh my God, Josie.
What?
Wow. Holy moly. Oh my God. Our house is freaking destroyed, Josie!
No!
Oh my God! Where's Autumn? Oh, I've never seen anything like it.
What do we do?
I don't know. Let's go. We gotta see if anybody else's house is up. Josie, come on. Hang on a second. Oh, Jesus H. I'm in shock. I can't believe this happened. Oh my God, Josie. The neighbors' houses are gone. Oh, damn, I hope nobody's hurt. Autumn, stay there. Come on, Josie, let's get out of here. The tornado's passed. We got to get out of here and get to... Josie, come on, now. I know it's scary. Come on, now. And wash your nails. That's fine.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
What no one knew about 35-year-old Charlene D. Herrera as her SUV was slowly swept towards deeper water was that Charlene, just coming home from work, still in her Wendy's uniform, trapped inside, couldn't swim. Which explained why she called her brother on her cell phone instead of just saving herself like almost everyone here, horror-struck and watching, was hoping she'd do. In sickeningly slow motion, with all four car windows shut tighter than a drum, Charlene and her car slipped into water about 10 feet deep and sank. The first to reach her was a doctor, but try as he did, that stick he had was no match for the safety glass.
I was pounding away, and she had her hands against the glass, and she was terrified.
And then Charlene was gone. Almost a full minute went by, but unbeknown to everyone was that Howard Absetz, a 43-year-old unemployed store manager, the man in the middle, had somehow reached through Charlene's front window.
For me to actually feel her grasp my arm was a real shock. And then the second time that she grasped my arm, I knew right then that I could get her out.
And then, up she came. Of course, no one knew Charlene couldn't swim, and there was a moment coming up here where she almost drowned the good doctor. But everyone eventually dragged Charlene to safety. But here's the odd part. When Charlene's car was towed from the water, all four windows were still closed. How they opened just enough to let her out and then closed again, no one knows.
There was something there. I can't explain it, but something happened for her to be able to be alive today, for me able to pull her out. Something happened for that to happen.
Something Charlene and Howard and everyone here is still wondering about.
But did you see the baby? Did you see the baby? His mercy and his grace was wrapped all around his child. Now I want you to take a moment, no matter where you are, and just think about the goodness of Jesus. Think about the things we take for granted every day. Now allow me to share these words of inspiration. My grace is sufficient for you. My strength is made perfect in your weakness. Let us come boldly before the throne of grace, that we may find mercy and grace in a time of need. God's grace is immeasurable. His mercy is inexhaustible, and his peace is inexpressible. And I want to leave you with these words. No matter what you've done that may not be so pleasing to God on a day-to-day basis, think about this. 1,000 times I've failed, still your mercy remains. Should I stumble again, still I'm caught in your grace. Until next time, you be blessed.